nationwide eviction ban was supposed to protect people falling behind on rent during the pandemic.
But tenants continue to fall through the cracks. Just released data shows people in Dane County apartments and houses are being evicted weekly, even though President Donald Trump's executive order presumably halted most evictions. Tony Galley is digging deeper into the impact of this housing insecurity.
For every 60 folks that are evicted, it's going to result in one death.
That troubling national statistic heightens concerns in Dane County, where since a federal moratorium on evictions began in September, more than 50 people have been evicted, 30 forcefully. Evictions can take place over lease terms on police calls.
Or folks who have lost housing, who have needed to what's called kind of double up or go live with folks that are in violation of their guest policy.
The Tenant Resource Center's Robin Serino says some evicted from their apartments believe alleged lease violations were ways around the moratorium connected to missed rent payments.
While there can be dispute here at the courthouse over the justifications for evictions during an eviction moratorium, there is an effort going on to try to head off evictions altogether involving the people with the most to lose.
You know, there's a high cost to turn over a unit. It's about $1,000 each time a unit is vacated. And for folks who even have an eviction filing here, even if it was dismissed, you know, that's on your record for 20 years here.
So mediation is taking place.
The mediator is just a neutral kind of person in the middle.
And mediation is allowing some renters to escape eviction with stakes high on both sides. In Madison, Tony Galley, 27 News.
Representatives of the Tenant Resource Center say 15,000 Dane County households remain on a waiting list for financial help to pay rent. The moratorium on evictions over non-payment ends January 1st, 2021.